Beach day. Oh, well, ever since I'm in America, beach days are always with you guys. With the group, with Bonnie, Ricky, Richie, me, Maisha, Kevin, and all the other people, so it's always been with you guys. So experiences wise, it's amazing. That's why every single year I'm looking forward to it. It's more fun.
Beach day to me is going to the beach. Spending time in the water when I don't know how to swim. Holding on to Kevin so I don't drown. Getting a tan with like 5 different shades of brown. Yeah, that's beach day to me. Good food, good company, basically.
Beach day is something that we look forward to all year. It is probably the one event that I think our group has always had without fail since I think 2014 actually. It's the one time where we're all free, we're all loose, we all get to really just kind of take a break from life. And we figured, you know, since we've been having it for so many years, we'll just keep having it. And because we're so disciplined now, we figured, you know, what could possibly go wrong?
Global hot zones, the coronavirus spreading.
Fears grow of a global pandemic.
A huge spike in cases in Italy.
Hundreds of cases in South Korea. New cases reported in Europe.
The CDC warned Americans to be prepared here at home that it's not a matter of if, but when.
COVID, obviously, it wasn't expected that it would get this bad. Well, me and Mirza, we started researching about COVID around November, I guess, because it was already taking place in Asia, but we never expected it to break out in America the way it did. So it was extremely jarring and disconcerting, obviously, because all these people are losing their jobs at the same time. The economy is crashing.
This pandemic started in Wuhan, China. I think probably around actually started around January, December, like January or so. And then it just spread and spread and it just somehow became this crazy pandemic. I mean, like a real insane pandemic.
We went into lockdown. Work and school went like on computers. Everyone was kind of stuck at home. We were all really, really worried that we would get sick. Maisha's dad would get sick. The adults, I think most of us were just worried about all the adults and our family members. And so many people were passing away, people our parents knew, family, friends. So we were really, really worried throughout COVID.
I had to continue work every day, and then you're hearing stories about people dying. It's been just truly, truly sad.
And then March happened, all the COVID started, and everything just stopped. My educational life stopped. My personal life stopped, but I do, alhamdulillah, I had some part-time job going, and that is continue even though my work was reduced because of the COVID. Other than that, family, much more time with the family. I spend way too much time with family because people are not going to work. Same thing, my dad is not going to work. My brother didn't go to work as much. My sister didn't go to work. So yeah, it has ups and downs.
I never thought I'd live through a pandemic, you know? And I just feel like I hate myself for thinking when I was in sixth grade, why don't I live in a more historical time? This is way too historical for me.
Everything, you know, is so hectic, you know, everything's being canceled, everybody being separated, kind of sucked.
Well, I've just been more like home and not with people as much, so I've been getting used to it though. Like I'm usually like out and about, and now I'm just more of a homebody, and I don't mind it that much. It's just like I go out when it's necessary.
I mean, usually, like, you know, I'm an outgoing person. I usually do a lot of dancing on the weekends, but COVID suddenly limited that. as far as human interaction, you know, all my interactions in the business, you know, at the store. But, you know, I've just tried to make the best out of it, you know, doing a lot of outdoor activities.
Me, Mom, Dad, Ricky, and Bonibu, we all had it. Dad had the worst. Fortunately, thanks to Allah, like, Dad is alive. Shukr alhamdulillah for that. Like, I wanted to do something about it, so I got, like, an antibody test. I became a convalescent plasma donor. But then I wanted to do more, so then I went back to ambulance school and I got my EMT license so I can go back to the front lines and help fight this disastrous disease.
I was working as a disaster manager during this whole pandemic. I have seen how people were suffering in every single way. It was not only about the disease. It was the mental stress, it was the economic stress. People were going through a lot. And this kind of situation this earth has never seen, and many of them didn't take it seriously. We have to think about it and act accordingly.
So since we quarantined so hard as New Yorkers and the summer is upon us, clearly everyone's stressed out, they're just fried, you know, and we're such a social group, we can't really be together. So the idea of a beach day around this time, while sometimes can be arguably irresponsible, I think it was very much needed. It was very much needed just for us to be together, to be outside, to be with nature, to be with the ocean.
Because we were going through so many tough times, it really, really helped and actually, I think, pushed the group to stay stronger and to make sure we do hold the beach day this year, no matter what, because just to like uplift, have at least something to look forward to. We've literally been locked up for like almost 3 months. So it was really great that the group kind of came together and made sure we had such a successful beach day.
It's nice to finally like socialize and have fun once in a while on the beach. It doesn't sound as dangerous because COVID cases have gone down a lot less. And it's been like 3-4 months since we've been like staying home.
The pandemic certainly changed everything. The world is really no longer the same now. And because we've been socially isolated for so long, because we've been quarantined, because we were in lockdown, because we haven't really seen each other's faces in so long, the beach day was certainly needed just to kind of give us a bit of a respite.
So this year, the beach, it meant a lot more than it usually does to us, because usually going to the beach is just fun, but this year we really took it to another level with like the tent and like all these people and then setting up a camp at the beach. So it was really, as Ricky was saying, a respite from whatever was going on, unfortunately.
So for quarantine, I've been stuck at home studying. You know, I'm still in high school. I have SATs and ACTs coming up. I haven't been out of the house in so long.
Let's try 2 over 7. What do you get? 2 divided by 7. 0.28. That's in between.
Taki is one of my students, actually. And right after the pandemic hit, we had to stop our lessons. But he and I decided to do online lessons, and he was actually kind of struggling with the format. I was too. I wasn't too fond with it. So Nipandi actually suggested during the pandemic, when it kind of got a little better, to actually come over to our house. So when I taught Thaki a few times, she was like, you know, she was mentioning how she really missed seeing Richie over, seeing Bonepu, seeing Maisepu, seeing everyone. So she suggested, actually, that, you know, whenever you want to come and teach Thaki on Saturdays, feel free to bring them over as well, because we love to have them. And that's really what started the idea for Pool Day.
Hey, what's up, man? What's up? Your lab ended early.
Oh, that's good. You know what that means?
What's up? Woo! Woo! Let's go! Let's go!
It looks cold, man. Is it really cold?
No. It's warmer than other days.
Go away, that's the only way you can.
Okay,
whatever.
Woo! And he's in there!
That was cold. And it's really cold.
We didn't think that a lot of us would be able to get together, and rightly so, a lot of us didn't. But so July 4th was really unexpected for us, because we didn't really plan anything, but we got together at Taki and Tasmia's pool at their house, which is amazing, by the way.
How deep is it?
10 feet.
6 feet, is that
10 feet.
10 feet.
Oh my God.
That's 5 feet.
12 feet.
Oh, 12 feet.
Oh my God, it's so deep.
I'm
need to teach you.
This is the training ground for the beach day, okay? This is the training ground.
And we didn't really plan anything, and because we didn't plan anything, it just turned out to be a beautiful evening.
This really wasn't planned. I wasn't really planning on doing anything. None of us were. And then we just find out that Taki and Tasmi are kind of not really having a pool party, but invited us for pool, to swim in their pool. And so took Kiki, Apple, Maisha, Mirza, Kevin, Ricky, which were already there. And we went there, and that was the first time Kikiapu had met Uncle and Auntie and Taki and Tasmia, and she really hit it off with them well.
Bonnie was telling me, like, Kikiapu, now you are going to have two more of our group that you didn't meet. So initially I was like, the way I am, I was a little hesitant to go to their places, but with time I found them, like both Uncle Auntie and Taki Tasmia. They are wonderful. They are like my own brother and sister.
I didn't even know Taki had a new house. I found that out only recently. And then when we were invited, we heard that it's a pool. We're having a pool party and stuff. I was like, oh, okay, swimming pools is something I'm really interested in doing. Then we met up there the first day, and I was like having so much fun being with everybody over there. We went up there, we got there pretty late, and so we thought we wouldn't have much sun, so we just kind of made the most of everything that was happening. But being in the group that we are in, we always make the most out of everything.
We got there a bit late, but I was super excited because I don't know how to swim that well. And beach day is kind of scary because the waves are super harsh. But so we had a pool. I learned how to swim a little bit better. I became a little bit more confident. Bonaipu taught me how to float. I didn't know how to float. I dived into the deep end. Thank you to Kevin, Bonaipu, and Maisha for rescuing me. And I think I learned how to swim a little bit better too by the second time around. So that was super, super cool. I love the pool. I love the water. I wish I could swim as freely as like Bonaipu and Ricky and Maisha and everyone. Not Kevin. I didn't grow up on the island. I don't expect that much. But like, hopefully a little bit better.
Ricky!
Ricky!
Help us!
Think of all the calories we're gonna lose.
We're gonna go to the other end.
We're almost there.
We're almost there.
Ricky, what are you doing?
We did it.
Help us!
We were just like playing games. Oh my God, I love Marco Polo. That is one of my favorite games.
Marco.
Changing, becoming daredevils with like surfing on it, and like that was my. And then the race, there was this one point in the second visit to the pool when we had a race, and then they stopped it the first time because Ricky was holding onto the wall, and that's really you're cheating.
On the count of three, 1, 2, 3. Ricky's cheating! Yo, Ricky's cheating! Ricky's cheating! Yo, Ricky's cheating!
Somebody kicked me! What a fool!
Yo, no! False start, he cheated!
Someone just kicked me and I stopped midway. And then when we raced again, by a little bit I won, and then Bonaipu was like, oh, I'm Arthur Curry. And Bonaipu was like, I gotta beat you. It was just so memorable of how all these events, how this whole I must thank Tasmia and Taki for inviting us so many times, and it's been a really, really great experience. I love that pool, I love the 12 feet, I love diving in it,
is just really, really something I'll never forget.
Oh my god! He's chicken! I knew it!
So before heading to the beach, everybody was kind of learning how to swim, like Boni Apu, Ricky, and Richie Baya, they're teaching everybody how to swim.
Letting you go. Just relax.
Oh god, I need to move.
Still, I'm scared of water. Everybody tried a lot to take me down and to teach me swimming, which I don't know yet. But I achieved this much level that I could float myself.
I'm getting better. I still have something like
something.
Like,
oh, God.
Okay.
It's okay.
Get it.
There we go.
Put your head in.
We're teaching Kiki Apu, teaching me how to backstroke, teaching me the basics basically for swimming so I can head into the waves. We're playing games, Marco Polo, you know. It was really great.
The last beach day, I was really scared of like the sharks, and I still am scared of the sharks. Even like last time, I was really scared and I didn't want to go in the water. But and I was scared to go in the deep end because I felt like I would drown or like not be able to swim. But I've finally learned how to swim, and I'm not as scared anymore to go in the deep end. So that's exciting because definitely before I was a lot more scared. But yeah, I've progressed a lot. And you guys definitely taught me.
I wish I have gone to more swimming days. I think I only swam twice, but I remember the first day. The first day was fun with Aki. Like I think that little rat tried to like insult me, so I just carried him through into the pool.
What's up, guys?
What's up? Oh, Richie, yep. Looking kind of looking.
What'd you say? No, we don't do it. No, sorry.
And then, I remember one time we were swimming in the pool. I think it was the big metal net. It was like diving in the deep end. None of us could try to hit it, but then I pulled an impossible move. Well, not really impossible, but I dived deep under to grab the net in the water. Oh God, swimming was so much fun. I mean, I prefer that than the beach, to be honest.
Okay, so this is probably the only time you're gonna see me in the water, because unfortunately for beach day, I'm not gonna go in the water, but hey, at least you get to see me.
Why don't you go in the water again on the beach day?
I'm worried about the salt water if it might affect my antibodies. It's just a little precursor.
Okay, sure.
Just a little. Alright.
Okay,
ready?
Yeah, you can go. Nice.
Rich, you good?
Yeah, I'm good. I'm just holding on. It's a little deep, so.
Alright.
We just had a great time, just like a real core group of us in that swimming pool. Is a great swimming pool, 12 feet deep, and that was so unexpected and so much fun.
The pool was only the first part. I mean, the night was still very young.
We went to Sonic, and now we ordered like a ton of milkshakes, so we're just trying to get the orders sorted.
Yep, this is us right now. Happy 4th of July. This is Mirza trying to sort everybody's drink out.
We all went to Sonic, and at the drive-thru we ordered huge drinks. Shouldn't have ordered huge drinks. Maybe should have gone for the kid's size after the pool. But ice cream drinks, super sweet. Definitely gained back all the calories we lost at the pool, but it was really, really fun to spend time with them. And then thank God they invited us over again. We hope we weren't that bad. So they invited us back, and hopefully we can continue this. It's super fun just to have something to do with the group.
All right.
Happy
4th of July. Woohoo!
Okay, that's fine.
We wanted to see some fireworks, so we drove around. And we went to get some milkshakes from Sonic. So we got our milkshakes, which was awesome.
Just taking a little break at 7-Eleven right now. Apple, you look so cute.
Dan, what are those?
my broken straw.
Sonic messed up, man. They're like the store that advertises shakes.
Yeah, they messed up.
And we had nowhere else to really like sit down, so we just went to a 7-Eleven parking lot and just stood around, drank milkshakes, and watched fireworks. And it was really a perfect quarantine July 4th.
Mirza, explain the straw situation.
Oh. So we got skinny, shitty straws from Sonic, and they all broke on
we
us.
We sucked at nothing came up.
They don't have the bitch-ass straws right there.
So, oh, yeah, so these are the weak straws. It all broke.
I technically borrowed a few straws from 7-Eleven. They were kind enough to lend it to us.
Technically.
Are we going to return it?
Technically.
We can if they ask for it.
Yeah. We can give it back to them.
Thank you, Masha, for having to go to 7-Eleven so we can get some real straws.
8 trigrams sealed.
We went to 7-Eleven. We had fun with, I guess, one of the relatives that came over. It was, like, so chill that we really wanted to make Beach Day a day like that, but even bigger. And it turned out to be just as great and just as amazing, and hopefully we'll have more coming.
Kikiapu actually invited us over for dinner, and it was the core group. It was me, Richie, Boniapu, Mirza, Diwanbai, Kevin, two new people were part of the group, who were also invited, Rafi and Akshura. So she invited us for dinner. It was just the kids, no adults, and we had such a good time. We had such an amazing dinner. It was so euphoric that, you know, I think, I don't know who suggested it, but at some point, everyone's like, yeah, let's do a beach day now. I think now that we're cool with visiting each other's houses, now that we're cool with, you know, coming over for this, we can certainly do a beach day. So it was at her house, I think, where we really began the genesis of the idea for a beach day.
I knew about this beach day for long after my marriage. That's how I became friends with this group. So I heard they go out at least once in summer to a beach, and that's like a huge deal. Because they plan for it, they go for shopping, they record it, and then it's like having fun together.
So here's what's going on right now. We're trying to actually account for
a
cost for water that we already agreed upon doing, but it's ridiculous depending on how much we want to spend.
And I'm fatter now than I was during the Harry Potter sleepover.
Beach day shouldn't be as complicated as it should be. It really should just be taking a cooler, taking a couple of hot dogs, maybe a couple of sodas, getting some ice, and just going there. I mean, most normal people don't plan for beach day. They just kind of go on the day of, and they just take whatever they need. We're not normal people. We like to go extra, we like to go overboard. We're certainly an anomaly with beach preparation.
You can get plastic for $5, or box water for $78. And that, if we get box water, it's a 14, we did the math, it's a 1400% increase.
As a group now, we try to fund all of our own endeavors, and shopping is actually one of my favorite things to get together. I got together with Ricky and with Kiki Apple.
What, are you pleased that Miss Red Cross here is
getting I'm so happy Apple's here. Apple
you
was
know
like,
why else he's happy? Yeah. Because you are someone who can talk over me and shut me down. And
no.
Nothing makes them happier.
No.
I'm just suggesting you.
No, I'm actually glad you're here too, because I hate being the oldest.
No, you need a check. We all need a check, okay? Everyone.
Anybody can stop me anytime.
No one's going to, because you make the most sense. No one's going to stop you. Okay.
And we went to Restaurant Depot, Costco, and I think Best Market. And it was just an adventure. The kind of planning and the, you know, buying things and the list. It was great. I loved it.
What else do we need to bring as a group?
That's it. We have everything. We have blankets, we have towels, we have chairs, we have tents, we have umbrellas, we have the laundry baskets, we have the garbage bags, we have the recycling bags, we have the coolers. Everything that we need. On,
I think I already put ice.
Yeah, on a logistical basis, we have.
Did I put ice? Mm-hmm.
It's Kiki Apple-sized bun.
Yes. It resembles like 4 buns will make my face.
Okay, now for real, where are the sesame buns, man?
Sesame. I went with Bonnie, Ricky Richie, with them for the shopping.
So, Oh wow, there's multiple flavors.
You coming?
Yep.
There's only one left. We went to a couple stores. This is just for you. Alright? Original Schweppes Seltzer. Happy? Okay.
So we were looking for seltzer water. Like, I know Maj bought a specific seltzer water, but I think we found, like, it was hidden. Like, Majibu's, like, Schweppes Seltzer was hidden in this one section that none of us could find, but Ricky was able to find it.
Me, Ricky, and Richie Baya, we all did a little preparing for the beach day. We had some, you know, snacks to buy, all that stuff. We went to Dixel's, we went to some groceries there, make sure everything was packed up and ready for the beach.
It's a robot! It's a robot! Yeah, Doc, you're a hazard.
Doc was chasing this robot. Like, we found a live robot in the wild. It was like, what's a robot doing here? So I had Doc go on and prank the robot.
It's a robot, Doc, it's coming after you! The robot's pissed off.
Just the logistics of shopping alone was, I think, crazier than expected.
So, Ricky, what are we completing today?
The last day of shopping.
But we have one more place to go, right?
Well...
Where is that?
Hopefully.
Wait, stop here. This is the line.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Yeah.
After going to three stores yesterday, or day before, me and Ricky did not find the coveted jalapeno ketchups, but this package just arrived, and thank you to Mommy for her donation. We finally got the jalapeno ketchup. This is the one, right?
It says jalapeno.
No, this is the one that you remember? Like, this is the what the bottle looks like?
Yeah.
Yes.
Right around this beach day, Mom and Dad, they leased a new Honda Odyssey, and we really wanted to kind of christen it with its first journey with a group.
Heyo, it's me. So, for beach day, we're taking the Honda Odyssey, and we actually have Star Trek USS Enterprise plates for it, or plate holders. We managed to get this USS Enterprise NC-1701 covers, so a little fun trick we did. While we were installing like Star Trek license plates holders, we use a Star Wars droid to screw in the license plates. That was like pretty funny.
I guess we can use the bottom one. Oh no, it's the bottom one. So we're done. Yeah.
All right, USS Enterprise is ready. Thanks, R2. All right, that's it.
The cars are the unsung heroes. I think just like last month alone, we added I think 1,000 miles. Just driving to Maishiba's house, driving to Taki's house, driving here, driving there, so I'm really glad that they got a little bit of significance this time.
So, big news, thanks to Ricky and Maisha and me, because my siblings are the best people in the whole world, we got together and we bought the ticket for Brian to come during beach day from Atlanta to New York. Yeah. One of my good friends from medical school, Brian Cunningham, he lives in, he's doing rotations in Atlanta in Georgia. He's from Tennessee. So bringing him over, he had a very short amount of time in between his rotations. So we were like, why don't you come over? And he really wanted a break. He hadn't had a break for over a year. So before his next rotation started, he wanted to come and he wanted to join us for beach day just to kind of see us all too.
Infection rate formula will be 10 per 100,000 on a 7-day rolling average, or 10% of the total population positive on a 7-day rolling average. So any state that has an infection rate above that would require 14-day quarantine.
So getting Brian was a whole another ball of wax. It became unnecessarily complicated.
So yes, this whole trip advisory thing from Tennessee and Georgia, it's not looking great.
Yes, I know. Governor Cuomo already announced that states, particularly red states, in which cases are rising for COVID, they those people coming into the state have to quarantine themselves for 14 days. But even though it's mandatory, it's considered an advisory, so there's no way to actually police them.
Okay, because like, for example, he already has a return flight for the 21st, so yeah, that's
they're not gonna check who's coming in and who's exiting. Like, they're not gonna police.
So
that.
he's not gonna be forced to not get on the flight, right?
No.
Like, he'll be able to.
I will call the governor's office tomorrow, and I'll get a transcript and I'll make sure that he's copacetic.
He's already freaking out because that's how he do.
I had to call the governor's office. I had to call various sites. I had to look up on websites. I had to print out legal forms. I had to make sure that, Ryan could safely travel to New York without any repercussions, and that, at least from a legal point, he would be okay with coming to New York. But ultimately, I think it turned out okay.
So that whole situation with him coming and whether he has a quarantine or not, thanks to, again, to Ricky with all of his research and stuff, he called the government, he called the State Department, found all the information. And long story short, there was really no issues. Brian did everything that he was supposed to do. There was contact tracing and he participated, and we just stayed responsibly. So it was a little harrowing for a second, but alhamdulillah, we got it done and no one got hurt and no one got diseased. So thankfully we were able to achieve that.
It really wasn't too terribly bad. I mean, the flight was pretty awesome actually. It was a reduced seating cabin. Had a whole row to myself, so everybody was pretty spread out, and everyone was wearing a mask, so it wasn't too bad. When I got to New York, they didn't even ask me any questions. I just went directly right out of the airport into the street, got picked up, no problem. And since I've been here, I was received a couple of phone calls and just some quick questions about my travel to New York, and other than that, that was it.
Well, the day before beach day, I kind of underestimated how much time everything would take. So I started making the mac sauce probably around 3 o'clock. I made the mac sauce and I left it in the fridge. And me and Kiki Apple had been on this Chloe Ting 2-week workout challenge because we wanted to, get fit. We knew we wouldn't see huge results, but we wanted to stick to our schedule. So, by hook or by crook, I was like, well, I'm going to go over, I'm going to do my workout.
Bonnie and I, we both were doing some exercises. We promised ourselves that we'd be a little better shape when we will be on the beach day. For our personal satisfaction. We are not wearing American beach clothes, but for us.
Went over, we did the workout, it was intense, so we're already exhausted. Then we come, me and Kikapu and me, we both shower and we get ready and she brings her stuff. So we come to the house, and then Maisha and Mirza come, Richard bring them.
So I just made 2020 beach days, 2020 beach days mac sauce. I'll show you the remnants of it later. Now we're gonna do a taste test. What are you guys doing?
Playing Ticket to Ride.
How is it? Brian, is it fun? Are you enjoying yourself?
This one. Doctor got screwed over a couple times, didn't she?
That was funny.
Poor doggy. Sweet doggy.
What is almost 8 o'clock? They're gonna go get Maisha and them in a little bit later. But in the meantime, they're gonna taste test the mac sauce. Okay.
Oh, Chicago?
Yo.
That's 4 points.
Put it in a finger. What it's supposed to taste like. So, taste it.
Well, let me just give it a point.
Can just put a finger in.
It's a little sweet. Let me just add a dash more salt.
Okay.
I love planning. I love getting things organized. This is something that I really take pride in. I love handling all the logistics and making sure that things run as smoothly as possible because, frankly, that's just how I'm wired. I'm not one of those people that can plan on the day of or that can just go with the flow. I do need to be over-prepared. It's certainly one of my quirks, but I think one of the drawbacks is not really taking a moment to breathe and just kind of relax.
Seems like a super tense game right now.
Ooh, we haven't we didn't shoot the shit or anything. We didn't talk or we literally just played the game, right? No one asked about the weather even, Jesus.
Can I have you guys...
And I'm not regretting, planning and stuff, but it was really nice just getting, an hour to just spend actual time with Brian, Daki, and Richie, just taking a break from everything and just really enjoying their company. So I think it was really needed to recharge my batteries. But the day was indeed very dense.
That day was condensed and dense. In the morning, I met up with my friend Harry, and then we took the EMT exam. Fortunately, both of us passed, so Harry took me out to lunch. Then I remember we all got home. I think Brian was here with us. Oh yeah, I think Brian and I, we did some shopping. Like, I got a new comic book that was with Muhammad Ali versus Superman. Like, we were doing fun stuff. Docky came over. I know me, Ricky, and Brian were playing Ticket to Ride, and Docky lost badly. It was so awesome. He's that little rat guy who deserves.
Okay, here we go. Me, 179 points. Richie, 130 points. Brian, third place, 116. Docky, 88 points. How we doing, Docky?
I don't want to talk about it.
No?
I don't want to talk about it.
All right.
I lost a lot of the games. We played a lot of video games. Brian was there. He's a great guy. Met him for the first time. You know, he assimilated into the group really well. Made a lot of white jokes. A lot of white jokes.
We're going to Woodside and Steinway, Astoria, to pick Masha, Poo, and Mirza, Poo, and Kevin. That's it, right?
Yes, and she's my co-pilot. She's been doing a good job keeping me wide awake. Because I'm not sleepy. I'm a safe driver, but I could use a little bit of a chow, you know, right now.
There's also a lot of traffic.
Yeah, which is weird for COVID.
Yeah, it's weird for a time like this. See you in the next shot.
So, we're picking up them.
I got the shotgun.
Hop in the car.
What's up?
What's up? Assalamu alaikum.
Looking like a star.
What's good?
Hello.
So I have some really good news.
What's
for
that?
The group fund. Guess who finally paid for his beach day after 1 year for being late?
Who's that?
Borno.
Oh.
He just zelled me the $15 that he owes me from last year.
Nice.
So we're awesome. We're $15 richer, guys.
No. The questions they're asking are so messed up.
They're so racist. Wait, so Ryan, have you ever had roadkill?
I know that it is a thing.
He's raccoon.
I've never even done raccoon. Never, never.
Really? You never play. You never play. You always say no, like all the time.
I don't know how to play.
You played last time.
And then we had the perfect set of eight people. It was like me, Ricky, Brian, Taki, Dasmia, Kevin, Maishibu, and Mirza. All eight of us were playing like Luigi's Mansion. It was just so much fun.
And the right one is to inhale air.
We're all playing Luigi's Mansion right now.
We're not using the word sucker blow, okay?
And fortunately, my team won. My team had like Dasmia, Brian, and Thagi, so that was awesome.
Kikipo has joined the party.
Hello.
How are you?
Hi, Kikipo.
No, you're wearing the same dress for three weeks.
Same. You know what? Because I don't have BO like some people.
Well, I don't have BO. I just have hygiene.
Hey, Apu.
Hello.
Pick him up. Pick him up.
Pick on that side too.
Oh, the camera almost died.
No, don't fall. I got the shampoo.
On beach day eve, there was a really strong sense of camaraderie within the group. We played a lot of games.
Well, this is our first major sleepover since the Harry Potter sleepover. I'll tell you that much.
Make a backy burrito.
Yeah.
One, two,
three.
Oh, Kevin, you're mad big, bro. Get off.
That's what she said.
I actually like somehow way less efficient than people.
Yeah, I love how everyone sobbed and yelled you two.
Okay, get your ass up. We got a curfew.
I don't!
Oh!
Oh.
Yo, he's dead.
Get up. I'm doing it again.
Right.
Two seconds.
Well,
three,
like...
two. Okay, let's go.
They just the boy just like it.
We slept all on the floor together. We had so much fun.
We're fighting over this pillow. Okay.
I'm just gonna do it for the video.
Okay, 3, 2.
Ooh, what if I break this?
Wait.
Wait, so you just jump in and get it?
Three, two, one.
God damn
it! I thought you didn't even want it. What is it?
Victorious. I keep it.
We have this thing where we can't really, like, start working until our parents kind of go upstairs and out of our hair. So we didn't really start cooking until way later. And that, I mean cooking by like making the burgers, like making the burger patties. So
I'm making patties.
I'm making the cream.
We're gonna make 20, I think 20. I might make them smaller.
Yeah, that's the most irritating part about making the patties.
Making the cream cheese.
We thought there was not enough, so then the meat had to like...
Yeah, because it is going to shrink.
Me making the... I made something called macaroni bechamel, which is an Egyptian dish. It was pretty good. Making all the components for that. And Kiki Apple making her mango cheesecake.
Here we have our beautiful Kiki Apple, who is making... What are you making, Apple? Tell us.
Mango cheesecake.
Yes.
So we will have some sweet tomorrow after our dinner.
Yes.
Main dinner is prepared by my dear Bonnie.
Hello.
And we started cooking. That was like, we started cooking around 12 o'clock, I guess. Like 11:30, 12 o'clock was our starting of cooking. And then whole night. Me, Bonnie, and also Tasmia didn't sleep even for a bit. And Maisha, yeah. So we had our helping hands together to work together. And first time for me making the mango cheesecake. I never made it earlier. And Bonnie helped me with the recipe. And then Rupa helped with the dishes. And Tasmia was like everything there. And Maisha also the same. So, and Bonnie, especially the chief chef of the whole beach day. Not only chef, like main organizer, making us together, cooking food, taking care, like the mama of the group. So it was fun.
You cover the sides with foil. It added to rumble the cover. And then when you put it in, it's boiling water here, so it's kind of in a water bath.
Okay. Cheesecake on the way.
Burgers.
Yay.
Oh, Bonipo eating.
What was chocolate?
You're tricky. And I'm eating from here.
Okay.
Oh, tasting from
okay.
here. So
oh,
now
yeah.
go the gloves are coming off.
Oh,
that's going to be a perfect fit.
Yes, look at the beauty. It's Food Network for Bengali
yum,
people.
Yum, yum, yum.
All the watermelon.
Oh, we have so many.
Both the camera.
Yeah, there is a watermelon eater.
There's a watermelon thief. Watermelon thief.
Melon.
Pose, girl, pose. Do
melon,
our best.
Melon.
We're doing all this work now. What time is it right now?
3 almost.
Seven,
almost
yeah.
3.
3. 2:57. Boys are sleeping, which means we ain't gonna do shit at the beach.
Not
they're setting up camp. They're setting up the tent. And we're just gonna lay there.
We'll be in the car. In the AC.
Oh yeah, definitely. The guys also fell asleep because Ricky and Kevin have this morning ritual where they go at like 4 or 5 in the morning, they're gonna get us breakfast and whatnot. So they were asleep in the basement and it was a great time. The girls were just dishing and hanging out. We were making jokes and cooking, and that was probably one of my favorite parts. It was, again, like an unexpected sort of fun. And those are the times where the memories are really made.
She's trying to get me.
Wonderful! You have cooties! Wanna pull that garbage?
Oh, hug her too! Let's hug her, hug attack together!
The garbage can.
Quickly!
Yep.
Combine up here! No, Ikan, it's all fluffy down
oh,
here!
No!
Yes!
Oh.
Hug attack!
The girls did not sleep at all, so we stayed up all night. We started cooking around 11, 12 ish. Stayed up all night helping Bonnie Apu clean the dishes, do whatever. She's our main chef. Thank you so much. So glad to have a chef like her around. But yes, we stayed up all night to kind of help her cook and make all the amazing yummy dishes that she did.
Usually Kevin and Ricky are running around, waking up early and doing everything that needs to get done early. But this year, the girls especially, like me, Tasmia, Bonnie Apu, Kiki Apu, Mirza, we stayed up all night literally just cooking because we planned a dinner after beach, which usually we never do that. We usually just eat at the beach and we have beach food, which is great. And then afterwards we just like get something or we eat the leftovers from beach food. But this year, because it was Bonipu's birthday as well, we wanted to have a dinner, have a movie, really go out of our way. And so cooking took so much time that we did not expect to actually not sleep at all. Like, most of us, most of the girls did not sleep at all. Like, not even a little bit. So I got to sleep a lot at the beach when I got to the beach. But yeah.
I was going to, like, take a nap, but, like, we were just having really interesting conversations and I didn't want to leave. I could have went upstairs if I wanted to, but I was having too much fun down, like, talking and helping to cook. So we all ended up staying up all night. And then, but then the next day at beach day, we ended up all sleeping for, like 30 minutes, I think. So we got a good nap. I think I only took a nap for like 15 minutes, but it felt like 3 hours.
Making the food, staying like up whole night, and everybody was having so much adrenaline rush, like nobody even felt it. Like they were up like 32 hours, more than 32 hours, I should say. And still they had full of energy to do all the things fun, watching movies, having food, cooking, baking. It was fun.
Traditionally for our beach days, which I think we started back since in 14, Ricky and I would wake up at very early in the morning. And we would start our routine. We would go, we'll get the ice, we'll get the, well, at that time it used to be hot dogs from Costco. We used to pick up like all the stuff that we would need, snacks, drinks, whatever, and then we'll come fill up gas and stuff.
Babalal, Kevin, he and I always do the morning routine. And what I love about him is he is always ready to go. I think literally on the morning of, I kind of nudged him and I gave him a thumbs up. He looked up and he immediately did this. So Babalal is my go-to co-pilot. He is someone who is always ready to go and always ready to support me, and he's a critical asset. But he and I, we woke up all the boys, and we had an announcement to the boys because something happened last night.
I just woke up exactly.
And he just woke up.
It's exactly 4 a.m.
Nobody slept here. We all are cool.
Yeah, we're all awake. Wide awake. Exactly 4:01 a.m. There's Mirza sleeping.
No one's
gonna be
on the water. Everyone's gonna be on the damn temperature.
No one, yeah. None of the girls have slept yet. It's crazy. Yes.
Watch me still not be able to fall asleep.
The girls, we just made the dessert, we made the dinner, and we made all of the beach food.
Look at this
now,
face.
Now, Ricky didn't make his hard ass onion ring hummus shit.
Takes 5 minutes.
Richie didn't make his pizza. But I still did grate the cheese for him.
4 minutes
now. So, it's not 4 minutes. So, great,
sorry.
You saw how long the cheese grating took.
Yes.
You saw, right?
I did.
So, basically, once we come back from the beach, we ain't doing shit. Girls are done. Boys are gonna be doing all the work.
Because we finished our work. That's it.
We chillin'. You're gonna put up the tent all by your lonesomes. Because we did all this.
Look at the dance. Look at this, brother.
No, but. You know who's gonna be the one to help him?
The okay, one, the only, Kiki.
Ricky, are you not happy? Are you not?
Sure, why not?
So none of the girls slept. It's 4 a.m.-ish. I said, is there any way you females can spare yourself so we can like take over the reins? They were like, no. So we're gonna try to insist at least to have us do something. So, rise and shine, boys.
The way I woke up on beach day was the first thing I heard on beach day when I woke up was the girls didn't get any sleep. The girls didn't get any sleep. So, you know, the boys were pretty much well rested, or with like around like 3 or 4 hours of sleep. You know, with the excitement of beach day, that's all we really needed.
You, we are you ready to go?
Do you know what else we did?
You didn't get your beauty sleep.
Oh, bitch, please.
Look at this beauty sleep.
Like your work day has started, Ducky.
Exactly. We are
you
done.
Don't get to insult him, okay? If I don't have a son, this is it.
Do you know who also emptied the freaking Herbie for you? Us.
No one asked you to do that.
Yeah, well, we did.
No one, literally no one
you
asked
see,
you to do that.
Apu, do you see this, like, lack of gratitude?
Exactly.
We did
everything.
No one.
She, you're disappointing Kiki, Apu.
No one asked you.
She, look.
Apu, I'm sorry, but that was our thing. No one asked you to do that.
But we did.
Why?
You can't
just thank you, at least.
Okay.
Two words, thank you.
Two words, said.
You didn't say it.
You have to say it in words, and then with the bracket, like.
You're not. You're denying Kiki up or right now?
No one asked you to do that. That's. This is what's called being a martyr.
Right? This is not being a martyr. It's called, it's called appreciation.
This is being a martyr.
Daki, huh? As the boy's little mascot, will you say thank you?
Don't.
Go gun on the head. You have to say thank you.
You know what's good for you? Bite your tongue. Bite it.
It's okay. I'll get one of those idiots to say it. We'll just get Kevin to say it.
No. Yo, tell them right now. Go, messenger.
Yeah, Brian.
No one says those words.
This year was different because one, we had to wake up really early because of the COVID situation, we had to be at the beach early. So we woke up at 4 a.m. Come to find out that the girls were up all night and they were getting cooking and preparing food and everything, which we really appreciated, and I must thank them for that.
Well, Mamo and I guess now Taki, we're gonna do the morning routine. Richie's still here. Enlist him to do stuff. He can do stuff. He will do stuff.
Yeah. He's downstairs.
Okay, just call him.
Okay.
All right.
So now,
Autobots, roll out.
Here's what all these beautiful houses is, like washing stuff. And then just rinse with the hobbit.
When we headed out, we went to get ice. There's nowhere open that early. Thank God for CVS. Hey, Mirza Maisha, CVS.
So every year, Kevin and I have a morning routine where we, you know, fill up the air, tack for the tires, get the ice for the coolers. Pretty much do everything that no one else wants to do, but this year it's a little messed up because none of the girls slept, so it kind of gets purpose of the morning routine.
Y'all ever heard the term wild goose chase? Well, now me and Ricky are on a wild gas chase. Looking for gas. Oh, God. Yippee. Well, gas chase. Oh god, no, not BP, please, not that. Not BP. I'm gonna pull over there.
So once Babalaw and I got the ice, we needed to fill up the gas for the cars. And obviously at 4 in the morning, only one station was open. It was BP Gas. We have a particular grudge against BP because a couple years back they spilled all this, like, millions and millions and millions of barrels of oil in the Gulf. They never properly apologized for it. They didn't really show any remorse. So we always said that, you know, if we could avoid BP, let's avoid BP. But, you know, of course we had to, you know, take it on the chin and go there. It was whatever.
When we pulled into BP, you could see the life leaving Richie's faces and Ricky's faces was like, oh, and I was just like, what are we gonna do? We just gotta make do with what we have. And, you know, we just had to do what we had to do. And then we went and we got bagels. Oh my god, that bagel was really good.
So we're here at 5:30 in the morning, getting 10 everything bagels with lux cream cheese. I don't have flat bagels, but anyway, can eat. At this point in time, we're just desperate to eat, so hopefully it's really nice. It's a big order.
So Kevin and I, we went to this bagel shop, and it was a nice, cute little local business. We got bagels and salmon lux, and it was delicious, and everyone got a chance to enjoy them, and it was cool, and I really hope it becomes a thing. It was expensive, but it was certainly worth it.
It was like so nice to support a local business. They had some fresh orange juice, which was really good, and that was a whole great experience just getting that. And then to head back, when we got back to the house, then they realized, oh my god, there's not enough ice.
Yeah, that's not gonna work.
And then me and Ricky had to like dart back out, go to CVS, pick up another bag of ice, and still all of this to leave in time for 7 a.m. Which is like crazy, but somehow or the other, just like every other time in the past, we got it done.
So, you know, this is how they do it back in the village, you know.
No, back in the village, no, this is how they do it back in the village.
Put it on the top.
Yes, they do over their heads. That's back in the village. Yeah, they do it like this.
Oh, yes. God. Idiot. Alright, when you guys are finished packing, we're gonna go down a list of everything everyone needs to have on them, okay?
We packed up all the stuff, made sure everything was ready. Make sure the cars had gas.
We were seeing the sunrise, and then I was walking a little bit on their deck in the back here. It was nice to see always, like when the dark goes away and the light takes place, and then we were ready with our all kind of possible layers to protect us from the sunburn. the girls especially, and the boys were busy with bringing the breakfast.
Yeah, we get like really nice Jewish bagels.
It looks mighty delicious, I might add in.
And lox cream cheese. Everyone go take your bagel. There's 10, one for each of us. The bagels were great. We had breakfast bagels. Really great. Sounding in it. So as the girls were getting ready, all the guys, Brian, myself, Thaki, Richie, Kevin, we were all just kind of just chilling in the morning at the glass table, having our bagels. It was really the calm before the storm of just making sure that everything was ready to go. But I think I only ate for literally 5 minutes, and then I realized I had to pick up Rafi at, you know, 6:30 sharp. I said 6:30 sharp, but really I was, that means 6:15 in my book.
I mean, turns out that Sunday we're going to the beach, so, you know, on Saturdays I'm wilding out. So someone's like, someone texted me like, yo, I'm gonna have to pick you up at 6:15. I'm like, yeah, all right. So I go to bed at 3, and then next thing you know, someone's waking me up. I'm like, who's that? And Ricky goes, I'm outside. I'm like, holy shit. So I just get out, put on my shirt, put on my shorts, just brush my teeth, no breakfast. I just pack my shit, and then, you know, next thing I know, I open my door and Ricky's outside with this big ass van.
Check the table.
Check.
Beach umbrellas.
Check.
Coolers.
Check.
Self-respect.
Blankets.
Check.
Check.
Laundry basket.
Check.
For check.
Oh my god.
Cycling bag.
Check.
Check.
All
the
tags.
The vine. Speaker. You're both speakers.
I didn't get that.
Let me get it. And that's Brian. That white guy's Brian.
Hi, Brian.
I'm the white guy.
The token white guy.
We need one white guy when we're alive.
I'm so sorry, Brian. That's my sister.
Right. Oh, nice to meet you. Oh, that's his sister. Yeah, I forgot to tell you about her.
She's the one with the do-rag.
Yeah.
You know.
That's a long time. She's from trying to be a Rasta. Oh, you should braid your hair.
This
you might
is
be a Rasta.
Hijab, huh?
A Rasta. You know a Rasta.
It's a hijab.
I want to braid my hair.
You
want to
braid?
I think I will.
I think you might look,
even before I do it.
Yeah.
Got my goggles, right?
I packed it in my bag.
You have everyone's goggles, like that you
okay.
Bought.
Yeah, I
took out my sunglasses.
Well, no, the ones who paid for goggles, they have their goggles.
Okay. I don't need.
Everyone has sunglasses.
Yeah. Nah, I don't need.
Okay, who wants it? Oh, you're fine.
Little brats are in the back.
Lotion, girls, shampoo,
I think Ricky has a shampoo.
Shampoo, body wash, you guys have.
Yeah.
Okay.
Have
hair brushes.
Yeah. Oh, do we have soap?
Okay, listen. One of them. Under no circumstances do we split up. Don't use GPS because we cannot split up the cars like last year. Oh, we got stuck in the traffic jam.
I've been
right?
looking for you.
Yeah.
Check the shades.
Do a final check.
The drive to Beach Day. So we left at 7:20. We planned to leave at 7, but still a pretty good time given the circumstances. Girls were in Herbie. It was me, Maisha, Brishti, Kiki Apu. Mirza and Tasmiya. Kiki was with the boys because Ricky demanded it.
You guys didn't sleep at all?
Me and Bonnie, totally, not for a second.
Me and Ricky got 3 hours.
I know you guys
yeah,
are
me,
excited.
Yeah, I got 3 hours too.
I know you guys are excited about that.
We were working. Me and Ricky got 3 hours.
Alright, here we are. We're heading to the beach.
Me and Bonnie didn't sleep for a second
either. Oh my
lord.
Huh?
Google Maps.
Who's following
going
you?
To the beach.
On the beach day, I was though with a different group. I was not with the girls. I was with the boys, but it was fun.
Yes, Kiki Poo's in the cool person's car.
It shouldn't take more than an hour, right?
Avengers.
40 minutes.
Assemble. Oh my God.
Does this mean I'm an Avenger? Yes.
Yeah. Keep up.
I'm an Avenger, you can tell.
Oh, Jesus!
Yep, that just happened. Oh, God!
But, so we were going, and Ricky said not to split up at all, so I was following him. And because, you know, he's like the planner extraordinaire, and sometimes he gets a little too vigilant.
Well, the ride there was pretty eventful.
The journey to the beach was unexpectedly expected, because right now, like at the time of the month that we're going to the beach, there's a lot of cops out trying to give out tickets.
Ricky was driving a little bit above the speed limit, and we got pulled over.
Okay, so shocker, Ricky went 82 miles per hour and we got pulled over by the cops. So shocker,
homie got us on a Sunday.
Ladies and gentlemen, clap for Ricky. Give him a round of applause.
I mean, to be honest with you, we had a pretty good playlist. That's why I guess we were all excited in the van. And I don't know if we were really doing 82, but it turns out that Ricky was feeling it. So guess what? Next thing you know, look in the back, you see sirens and flashing lights. So he gets pulled over by a state trooper. So I'm like, holy shit, I'm all the way in the back. And if you know people, you know the people that sit all the way in the back, they always got something up to their sleeves. So I'm like, what can I do? So I know my shit was expired, so I pull out the PBA card and I just hand it over to him. Just like, don't even say nothing, just show it to him.
But Rafi had his card, PBA card, it was expired. But I also had my PBA card and my my brother family shield that every family member gets. I have that too.
Bonipu slowly creeped in behind the cop and just stood there. And the cop, when he got out of his car, was just like, hey dude, what are you doing here? I didn't stop you. But he saw that we were a group together and she even said hello to the cop, which I don't know how he took.
I just went right behind the cop and it was really funny that it was a state police. Of course it was state police. So the officer comes out, right? And he looks at me because I like followed him to, you know, the curb. And he looks at me and I just wave at the officer like, what up? I thought that was pretty funny. And I'm sure he found out that we were together. And we were just sitting there like, what the hell? Like, oh, of course.
He asked me about my brother. I was like, yeah, my brother works in 46 Tucson. He's the NYPD. And yeah, we literally, because of that, and probably he was nice enough to let us go. He probably realized that we're trying to go somewhere really early, I guess, the beach place.
Thank you so much.
Holy shit!
Where's my PBA card, motherfucker? Where's my PBA card, motherfucker?
Look at that shit. It's gonna work.
Yo, clap for the one,
guy. Everyone, clap for the one, man.
But it was great because we got off thanks to Rafi, who had a PBA card. Thank God. Like, we need connections everywhere, guys. That's just really what it taught us. But yeah, we got off without a ticket and no points, thank God.
And then he got in the car. We didn't see him write a ticket. And when he drove off, all the girls in the car, we just cheered. We were like, yes! We just screamed and we were just yelling. And of course, we called Ricky, gave him an earful, and we were like, thank you, Rafi. It was hilarious. It was just, Allah came and just saved us and gave us a funny memory, so that was pretty hilarious.
Yeah,
There's my shibu. Oh, she's filming with the portrait. My shibu.
Put in a jungle bug by.
Stop filming like a boomer.
This is all boomers.
Alright, we'll let you film.
This is how all boomers film. Like this? Yeah.
We'll let you film.
In portrait. Do it.
Cool. I didn't know filming in landscape was a thing.
Yeah, me too. I never
portrait. It doesn't really look nice unless like you're literally taking like a
full body.
Yeah,
picture.
Take the freaking. Yeah.
I'm not gonna film anymore, bro. Like, I'm
it's okay. I have mine on.
Good, everyone, film. Who the fuck is fucking Bucky? It's fucking Bucky. Poor. Look at that. Look at my shirt. Look at Bucky. It's so nice.
Oh my god. I literally can't see anything in these sunglasses. Mm. They're hella dark.
Beach was closing by 9:45 a.m. So of course we had to make sure that we go the way before, just to get in place, and thankfully we did. But yeah, it was a different, it was lot less people than I expected. I expected the way the traffic was, I was like, okay, we might not be able to get in, even though like, it was 10 minutes before they opened up. But I'm glad that it opened, and I'm glad that we had a chance to go in, and it was nice.
And they made it! Oh my god, what's she doing? Alright, we're all here. Everyone accounted for.
During this COVID time, this social gathering is not something that is right to do. But I have watched them that they maintained the protocols. They were pretty healthy about and conscious about their health situation. And we were in a group and we made distance from the other groups in the beach.
We took all the precautions that we were supposed to. We wore masks where we should. We stayed away from other people. and the beaches, of course, of New York, I mean, even with such low numbers, they're at half capacity. So I think, yes, some people may argue it may be irresponsible, but I think given as that we are New Yorkers and the way our group was, it was needed. It was like a tonic.
Every year we keep improving and improving. Like before, we had like a huge umbrella, I think the last year or the year before, which really made it great. Like we'd all sat that time, Jenny Apu and Saibai and stuff were there. So we had a nice circle and everything, and it was like a big umbrella. And I just thought, like, this is the pinnacle of what a beach day is. I mean, we're already outdoing many people around us. This year, thanks to Bormama, we had a tent.
Okay, what are we doing?
You ask Brian, I have no idea.
Brian, what do we do? Ayúdame!
Brian, this is inside the tent. Oh, those metals.
What's up? What's up? How we doing? How we doing?
Where are the honeys at? Zoom in on the honey.
Ask about honey.
Listen, zoom in on the honey.
For honey.
Oh, yeah. Listen, gotta be redhead, brunette. Blonde is okay. Blonde's
not bad. You need this, Brian?
Yeah, let me have this.
And that tent, well, putting it together was a bit of a chore because we didn't quite understand how to tent, the whole tent situation worked. I know some people were able to get it done. Ricky was saying in a minute and a half. We weren't so fortunate. We did take a little time.
Rotate. Go, Diego, go! Ring around the roses, the ashes, the roses, ashes.
Do you want my walk it closer to camp?
Yeah.
All right, come this way a little bit. Swing it closer to camp, walk it closer to camp.
Okay, go.
I think it looks good, right, Brian?
That's it.
Place it.
Okay, now we got anchor.
It takes 20 people to set up one tent.
The girls ended up having to help us anchor it down and everything, but we were able to get it up and it was totally worth it.
Yo, to be honest, I have not been near the water in like 8 years. So we go to the beach and it turns out we're finessing everyone. We got this big ass tent. It's like a big ass house. It's like a room, right? You could like fit in like so much people.
But I'm gonna be sad.
I got it.
Dad bod season, baby.
We're 13, by the way. We're 13. Get him.
Brian should be in there too.
Well, obviously, he's our security.
Brian, get in.
Oh, I forgot Diwan. Diwan is with the
wall. You said your name so sexy too.
You said Diwan. Because you know you are Diwan.
I had to change for Brian.
Yeah. You have lipstick on?
Oh, I share your...
I have normal chapstick, Kevin.
I thought it was chapstick.
So I would say we had probably like the top three best tent and campsite on the beach. I'm pretty sure we had the like at least top three. You know what I'm saying? It was perfect. Our tent was huge, had privacy. We had a lot of chairs, food, snacks, drinks. Perfect distance from the water.
Trying to be serious about it, I really don't like trying to put all the plastic.
This year's beach day was probably the best. We were at our peak when it came to planning, setup, everything. If you guys see, it looks perfect. We had the tent, we had kind of like the tarp in the middle, and then we had seats lining up to the tent. We had the table with the umbrella in the front. It looked like a whole setup. We were definitely the most over-the-top extravagant bunch on the beach, but we were super prepared and everything went as according to plan. Perfect.
Oh, the setup this year was the most amazing that I've ever had at the beach. We had a freaking tent, like a huge ass tent. Sorry to the parents who are listening to this, but we had such a big tent and we looked like the most audacious, gaudy group on the beach.
Also, I'm gonna pray. I thought first thing for the campsite, make sure it's safe. I know Richie's here. But just when you walk around and stuff,
yeah.
Still, and pray before you go.
Yeah, we'll go. I'll say at the place before I leave. So,
Richie, like, get your ass over here for a second. I'm
not gonna say like, me, Kevin.
The weather was fantastic. The setup was incredible. I guess probably the best thing was just the setup. I mean, it was a legit, you know, beach party setup, food, a huge tent. I mean, we, as far as I could tell, we had the best setup on the beach, so.
And people were just like staring into our tent. Because there was a portion where we were at the beach and we were all saying duas, praying for each other and each other's families and loved ones. And people were just, I could see people looking into our tent and going, yo, these people are praying, y'all. And then, yeah. So it was just such a big, massive circle. So I don't know if people thought we were like a cult at the beach. Like we're having our little cult meeting at the beach, probably. But it was great. I loved it.
We formed a nice circle. Even people are passing outside. I heard one of the girls saying, and they're like, oh, people are saying people are praying in there. And that's something you don't hear about often.
Okay, you guys, Kikiapo, since this is your loss, I think you should say a few words.
Like the uncle, he died actually yesterday. So when I heard first, I was talking in a position that I want to come here. But then I thought, like, okay, it was planned for long, and I didn't want to ruin it. So he was my dad's like childhood friend and very, very close to us, like my sister and my siblings. And he didn't die because of COVID, but he died because of heart attack. So it was his second time. He had a bypass earlier. So yesterday I was really sad about it. Just, we can just pray for him now. Nothing will go to him other than praying. Yes.
So this time in Beach Day, it was during a pandemic. You know, even though New York was doing pretty well, we're still in a pandemic. And recently, Kikiapu's, a friend of her father's had passed away, like, the night before. So that was, you know, that was a big emotional hit for her. She grew up with this person.
We all are passing a very tough time for the COVID. And we lost many of our relatives, friends, family members. And many of them are sick. So we wanted to be thankful to Almighty, and also we wanted to pray for them who has left them for the eternity, so that God will keep them in a better place than they were here, and who were suffering, we wanted to pray for them as well.
I had a thought that, because we come together as a group all the time, I feel like if we actually ever really going through anything, or if we have like a test or a job or anytime where we need prayers, I think we could probably call on the group to like maybe do little duas like this and prayers.
I propose that Diomba learns this shit.
Yo!
Yeah!
But I think from now on, if anyone, you know how like we always ask like in masjids for this extra prayer, for this dua or that dua, for whatever, I think we should all kind of like call on this group too, that we could all, I think we could make this a thing.
When we prayed for her uncle, we also realized that there's so many people that have died. So many that we know and we don't know, like over 141,000 at this point in New York, I mean in America alone. Brian's grandmother had died and his uncle had COVID. So we just sat together in a group in the tent and we decided to pray together and to pray for, you know, everyone's forgiveness. And it kind of gave us the idea that this is something we could do more commonly, where the groups just, you know, anytime we need prayers, we can all pray together. I really like that addition and I hope this becomes a tradition.
I think having a prayer at Beach Day was really the best idea. Thank God we had a tent. Thank you, Bar Mama. So we all sat in the tent and kind of prayed for all the relatives, all the loved ones that were lost. It kind of made Beach Day worthwhile. Like, even though we were having fun while the rest of the world was kind of going through a lot of turmoil, it kind of made it worthwhile, really, just to sit, remember everyone that's kind of lost their lives, gone through a hardship, and then continue on, even, you know, with our day.
We really outdid this year. This year had to be the best in terms of like how our accommodations, how our organization and everything was.
Let's shake it!
Richie!
Shake it!
You're gonna be here, right, Richie?
Yeah, I'm gonna come back when you guys rock me. Yeah, that's it.
Whoa, this is definitely better than nothing. It's to God.
Okay.
Yeah, I'll be here. I'll come from you guys for a bit and then I'll be back. Yeah.
Oh shit, I have my water glass.
Oh, okay, they got those. Hey!
Isn't that amazing? Ryan, you want some water?
D1!
I just had some.
I'm a natural eyesight like Babalo. These are real eyes. Trans eyes are real eyes too, okay?
Oh, God.
And Bonapu. Bonapu doesn't wear glasses.
Oh, sorry, I realized you didn't have those when you were born.
Hey! Hey, he's being
crazy. Brian doesn't wear glasses.
So I wanted to get a nice pic so I could flex for the gram, you know what I mean? So it was just Mia.
Me and Brishti, we were just taking pictures for Instagram and like social media and stuff like that. We're like the same age, kind of like 2 years apart. So we're on that social media phase where we just want to post all the time.
Hey, yep, we're going in.
The Aquaman's going in. Alright, get ready!
I gotta send one. Arthur Curry!
The ocean is great as usual, even though this was a new moon, and we went mad early, so real high tide didn't actually come until the afternoon. But for me specifically, it was just so sunny because we never go that early. I think my eyes they've been getting very sensitive to the sun, so it was hard for me to see, but I still, you know, despite whatever little changes, it was super fun. Just like in that water, that push and pull, the waves, riding the waves, and all of us being together near the water and laughing.
Go in the water, boy!
Since this is my first beach day really being confident in my swimming skills, I had a lot of fun in the waves. And although my swimming skills were pretty decent, the waves were really scary. And I constantly thought there was going to be a huge wave, so I kept saying, "Watch out, watch out!" But it was really just like a regular wave.
Of course, Taki made it extra fun with his, "Watch out, watch out, watch out!" There was no waves, and he would still be like, "Watch out!"
You know, I'm where the honeys are at, so, I mean, that's a good thing for me. I mean, listen, we had a lot of fun, you know, the waves were kind of, you know, taking it easy on us, but I really enjoyed the time, you know. The company was good, the people were good, and, you know, end of the day, the experience is what that matters, and I had an amazing experience.
And Rafi was like, to everybody, he would just be like, "I'm coming for ya." And these guys, everybody was so involved and so into it. It made it wonderful.
The gang's all here.
This time the waves were, I guess, the best for people who are scared of the water. And we had quite a few of those in our group. We have Mirza, we had Kiki Apu, we had Brishti. So these three are the most hesitant about the water. But because the waters were so, I guess, mellow enough that we could enjoy, but not too mellow that we would just be like in a wading pool, I think everybody got to enjoy it.
We had a lot of fun the first time. It was cold. But outside of the heat was scorching, so we were glad to be inside the cold water anyway. And then we quickly adjusted, and it was so much fun, you know, getting accustomed to the waves. It wasn't really as high tide as usually when we go, because we usually go in the evening time. But the first time was really good. Everyone was there. We had lots of fun. Trying to get Brishti and Kiki Apu in the water was quite a challenge. Ended up getting Brishti in mostly for the second time we visited, and we got in there.
My favorite part of today was definitely going deep in the water, because I didn't think I was gonna go in that deep, especially because I don't know how to swim and I was scared. So the simple fact that I went and the water was like up to my neck, it was crazy, but I did it and it was so much fun.
She actually came and it was a lot of fun with her. Lifting her over the waves and teaching her how to go over it. Being with Ricky, Diwan, Maisha, everybody more in the deep. Mirza came out really a lot in the deep actually this time, which I'm really proud of her for how much she uh, she could have done this year. She almost was as deep as with us when we go out. I would have to say that was really memorable.
This beach day, the water was cold, but it wasn't rough. And I have definitely improved a lot. Maybe thank you to the other beach days and the pool days. But the waves were super cool, which allowed me to go much farther than I ever have gone before. I think I was a lot more confident. I didn't get drowned at all this time, so it was super cool. I was able to have fun with the rest of the crew, not like cry by the water edge, so thank you.
And Mirza, I have to say, I was hella proud of her. I was so proud that she came so far. She didn't know how to swim at all in the last beach day, and this time she practically joined us. So good on you, Mirza. That was amazing.
Poor Abu.
Truly speaking, I didn't swim, but I floated a little bit. I got 2 times total nasopharyngeal wash with saline water, but it was fun.
Kiki Apu, proud of you for going up to your waist. I know you're afraid of the water, so inshallah maybe next year you'll go up to your neck, you know, we'll see.
Every year we like to one-up ourselves, every year we like to go the extra mile and see what we can improve. I think this year we made sure that whoever wanted actual swim goggles got them so they could really enjoy the water more. We bought goggles for Mirza, for Kiki Apu, for Rafi, and it was just, it's not necessary, but it's a nice touch so that they could actually like kind of enjoy the water more.
It was a lot more fun. It was just like very salty. But other than that, the goggles helped. But yeah, that was fun. I was definitely going into the deep end and going with the wave and swimming with the waves.
The water was certainly tame, but it was really fun because I think because it was so, it wasn't like tame, but because it was somewhat gentle, everyone got in the water and it was an absolute blast. Swimming, you know, being together, somewhat social distancing, but not really, but really, really, really just, you know, just letting yourself be at the mercy of the ocean. And it was euphoric. Richie unfortunately didn't go swimming because he has some personal issues that with respect to water.
Why didn't I swim on beach day? Well, it was just a little phobia of mine, a personal fear. I mean, it's just like, I was scared for my health because I wanted to like continue donating convalescent plasma. So that's why I didn't go in the water. I was like, worried for my health. I know like going to the beach or going into the swimming pool water, takis was also at the same risk, but I felt that was like safer for me. So instead of me not going in the water, I mean, I was like filming everything, and I did get my feet wet, so that was pretty fun. I just sat in the chair like all day, I was drinking some sodas, and yeah.
I didn't want him to be alone. I didn't want Richie to be alone, so that's why I left the first round pretty early. And he was at the campsite by himself. No one took pity on him because, you know, he's fine. He's fine with being by himself. But I wanted to spend some time with him, and I wanted to, you know, just let him know that, hey, you know, we appreciate you. We appreciate, you know, you obviously like watching over the camp. You know, just because you're not with us in the water doesn't mean you need to be left out. So I spent some time with the mini games. It's our thing.
All right, we're all just chilling here.
Yo,
do it again. Yeah. There it is.
This is gonna be a fun documentary, I'm telling you.
Favorite part of the beach day? I might sound old, but just being around the table that we always do in a circular motion, so we can see each other's face. Just talk about simple stuff. Just to see how things, you don't have to have some serious conversation, but you know, just to, whenever in the situation that you're in a circular table, everybody have a chance to participate. That's all it is. To me, it's a beautiful thing. Because you never know when things gonna change. You never know when you're not gonna see some other person. So it's a beautiful thing.
How's eating in the tent?
Yeah, we're all just chilling.
good work on this burger.
I just ate some Zan and
Alright, thank you ladies for staying up all night. Yeah, we appreciate
you.
It.
Thank you so much ladies for all the good.
Thank you.
Wonderful, wonderful burger.
Hey, back, give me some
apple.
Yo, let me see the pictures.
Okay, yeah.
But Richie, you like DC too, right?
I
like
how was your one. How's your Spider-Man ice cream?
No, guess what? Richie,
let me lick it first.
For all of us. He's the one who watches the most DC shows.
Yay. It's fruity.
He's seen all of them.
It's really good.
So we just finished eating.
Thank you, Molly.
You're welcome.
All the Marvel shows, he's seen Agent Shield and all of them.
He watches the most like
these ones are sleeping in here.
With me, I do the most comic book gaming.
That's Dasmia's feet. Mice is on the other side.
Is Hulk the one that tips it? Or if it wasn't for Hulk, would you be 50-50?
Yeah, like, let's say Hulk is not in the Marvel.
No, the one back there.
Hulk was not in the Marvel. What do you mean, like?
Let's say you put Hulk back to like. Not Marvel.
We even, most of us napped inside the tent once in a while after swimming so much.
Look at these two freaks.
So I fell asleep. I dipped in the ocean twice, and then after having lunch, I knocked out. And I'm sure you'll see a picture of it, probably covering my face. But yeah, I really enjoyed the tent so much so that even though my body was burning inside of it, I just had to nap. It was great. It's relaxing as hell.
A major consequence of the girls not sleeping and the guys only getting 4 hours of sleep was that, you know, at some point people were exhausted. We already had done 2 rounds swimming. We wanted to do one more. I think when it was suggested, let's do one more round of swimming, you know, all the guys were like, hell yeah, and all the girls were like,
oh my god, first of all, Bonnie and Maisha, you guys missed out. Third round was probably the best one. Waves were amazing, water was nice and beautiful, it was just the right temperature. We had a blast. And everybody was missing you guys. I really thought you guys would come and share with the experience with us, but obviously you guys were too tired.
The water was kind of chilly in the morning. But you know, it was like 1, 2 o'clock, like probably 1:30 ish, and it had gotten really hot on the beach. The water had kind of warmed up a little bit. There was quite a bit of undertow, so we had some really, really big waves. I mean, it was by far the best swimming of the whole trip. And yes, you, whoever's watching this, if you're female, you missed out.
Oh my God, the third time the beach was just. What we always meet when we visited, the big waves started coming in, and I was just like, wow, I'm so sorry that some of the girls were so tired, I guess from waking all night that night before, that they weren't able to enjoy it. They weren't able to go out for the third time, but the third time for me was really my most memorable time being in the beach, because it was really when the waves started kicking in. And I think Brishley came in for the third time, which was really a lot of fun, and everybody enjoyed the third time. So I would say, yeah, the beach sums up pretty much a complete success.
Brishan Mirza did not miss round 3. Me, Maisha, and Kiki Apu did. Kiki Apu was done swimming. My face had gotten, like, burnt. Clearly the Revlon foundation wasn't good enough. I have to stick to makeup forever. Maisha passed the hell out in the tent. And I forgot that we hadn't slept at all that night. We hadn't slept the night before, so we were dead tired, and really I was just disheartened with how dark my face had gotten. Real complex, whatever. But apparently, according to the boys, it was amazing, and the water was even better. So yes, we might have missed out, but to be honest, I still had a lot of fun, because we sat around at the tent and our campsite, and we just talked and had fun and basked in the sun and ate and drank. So I still loved it. Like, we missed out, but we didn't really miss out.
I did not go to beach day this year because of Corona. That's number one. Very risky. My mom has asthma, so I'm not trying to, you know, pass that on or anything.
It's too hot. You guys went at 7 in the morning. 7, right? That means I would have to get to your house. I would have to wake up at like 5 in the morning. Why would I do that to like... burn, like, yeah, it's a suntan. I'm already brown. I don't need none of that. I don't want to go underwater. I don't like to swim. I don't like sand. I get in my asshole. I don't want that.
So Javin and Borna wussed out. They like... Yeah, I'm sure they have some valid reasons with COVID, but so do we all. But really, I think they didn't want to go because they're just a bunch of sissies. But we planned to meet them at the house for the movie afterwards.
By the time we came home, every year, this is our tradition, we do beach day and a movie. Which is, it's easy to do because we go to the theater, we get some popcorn, we sit down, we relax.
This year, obviously, because of COVID-19, we were not able to, the summers are not open yet to go and see any movies. So we kind of improvised, and what we did is we had a home movie.
Obviously, the basement was perfectly set up. It had a projector, it had a screen, it had the space. It was the ideal movie theater given the circumstances. But because we weren't actually at a movie theater, there was no popcorn, there was no snack stand. That's when it was suggested earlier on that we needed to have dinner kind of cooked ahead of time.
I had the brilliant idea of cooking a whole ass dinner, like right after beach day, which was dumb as hell. So, 'cause it was so labor intensive, oh my god. Way too much work.
The food was good. I think we had some delicious cheese pasta, whatever it was, with some salad. That was really good.
Oh, the dinner was really good. The pasta was really good. And the pizza was good too. And the onion rings and the cake.
That was my first time making like a mango cheesecake, so I was a little shaky. I was not very confident about it. Initially, I planned to make a mango flan, and I did a trial, and that was a mess. So I didn't want to make it again, and I wanted to do something with tropical taste. So that's why mango, like I love mango. So that came up in Bonnie's mind, like why not a cheesecake? I said, yeah, that's a good idea. And she was instructing me all the time, telling me what to do next, and it came out good, surprisingly, though it was first time. And the decoration I did, I tried to make a little mango rose over the cheesecake. That looked pretty, I think.
You are the Bengali microscope.
Finally, guys, dinner's ready.
You're not ready. Get in the frame.
Ooh, what is this? This looks good.
Ricky, are you excited for beach day dinner?
Like hello.
No, that's not it. Just this. Just the salad and the pasta thing.
If you guys can take a makeaway downstairs, don't sit in the family room. Just go downstairs in the basement.
Yeah.
Yeah, don't go in the family room. Just go downstairs in the basement.
Oh, yeah.
Take large portions, y'all. Take large portions.
So finally got the food ready. Then we sat down and we started eating. And Ricky chose the movie Knives Out, which he prevented me from watching in the theater. So I was really excited to see it. And it was probably the... It was like the perfect movie. It was great because it was something totally different. It was something, it wasn't like a genre, like a comic movie or a sci-fi movie or anything like that. It was just a good movie, murder mystery. It was just so good.
I had to make sure that the movie this time was something that everyone loved. I mean, we all have such eclectic tastes and we're all so different that it's difficult all sometimes to find a way that, that's kind of like a one-size-fits-all. So Knives Out, I think, I picked because it's an ensemble movie. There's a lot of insane characters. And in a way, I thought it kind of mimicked our group. So I wanted a wild murder mystery. And I thought it was something that hopefully the group enjoyed.
I think it was amazing, the fact that we did movie day after beach time. I think it was a good way to kind of like unwind.
That experience was like oddly more enjoyable somehow because we got to control the environment a little more. We could eat dinner and we were watching the movie, and I loved the movie that was chosen. So it was awesome because we can even comment back and forth while we were watching the movie. So it was more personable.
I honestly like this just as much as being in a cinema, because in the theater, because the fact is, the movie that was chosen was excellent. And I would have to say, I don't want to spoil the movie for anybody who hasn't seen it yet, because I don't know who will be seeing this documentary, but I would highly recommend Knives Out. It is the perfect suspense, mystery, and a really, really, just a really good movie to see, and I highly recommend it.
I'd already seen the movie, but and not to, I mean, total honesty, I was kind of nodding out because I was a little exhausted by then.
The movie in itself was amazing. I personally was really tired because I didn't go to sleep last night, so I kind of like fell asleep midway because I knew what was happening, so I couldn't keep my eyes open.
There were a few times I passed out because I was dead tired, but I loved it.
Yeah, the movie, I was only awake for like half of it. I kept knocking out because I was so tired from not sleeping the night before, but I got the gist of it, so it was cool.
I was not up the whole time of the movie, so I was taking nap here and there, and Maisha was sitting just next to me, so I was asking her all the updates, like, hey, what happened? And once all those tensions started in the movie, it was so much fun. It was so much fun to watch, and as I missed some of the parts while I was sleeping, I'm actually planning to watch the movie again. It was a good choice.
But overall, the movie was good. And I think everyone had a good time.
My house.
Ah, my rules, my copy.
Damn.
Yeah. Of course, after the movie was over, and I mean, we had all that food, and like, and even after we ate before the movie, we ate after the movie. I mean, it was just an unbelievable atmosphere. I mean, everybody was having a blast, great conversation. I mean, everybody was really feeling festive, and I mean, it was a great party.
Just being around a group that we have, we always make it work no matter what it is we have to do, because we're Ricky always organizes things. I know how he operates because of Disney. He sits the night before and literally lists out everything, so that helps a lot. And then the group that we have are really cool people that just are pretty much flexible with anything. And so everything was a complete success. Movie night was great. I love movie night.
It was good, you know, typical night at Ricky's, you know. What did we do? I don't remember.
Alright, so we had Beach Day on July 19th, and my birthday was the day after. To be honest, every year, because I insist so much, I'm like, I don't care about my birthday, just forget my birthday, forget it, forget it, forget it. It's no big deal. I always assume that maybe this time no one's gonna make a thing about it, you know? And everyone was so tired, and Beach Day was on the 19th. We had already done so much. We were already hanging out together so much that I figured, this is the birthday thing. Like, you know, it's fine.
I thought for some reason that her birthday is a couple of days later. But then I realized last year at the same time we did something, then I was like, oh my god, yeah, it's Bonnie's birthday. Sorry about that, Bonnie.
Bonnie was a surprise party, which is extremely funny because I tend to do the same thing over and over again every year, but she never realizes what I'm doing.
She didn't have a clue. I mean, like, everybody kind of kept their mouth shut as far as like the actual surprise.
A few days before, I made a group chat with Maisha, Kiki Apu, and myself, kind of to go to plan through how we were gonna keep Bonnie up away from the surprise party while the boys were planning.
We made a separate WhatsApp group so that Bonnie doesn't know what is our plan, and we wanted to make it happen. So the plan was like the girls group will go out for a tea or like a little chit chat or like a driving out at night without any destination. And the boys will arrange all the party, like the cake and the balloon and stuff.
Maisha and I went out, we bought her card, came back, made sure everyone signed it, and made sure she definitely didn't find out what was going on.
For Bonnie Apu's birthday, we all had to sign one card. It was pretty scary because we had to do it all without Bonnie Apu noticing, and she notices everything. So that was really scary.
We tried really hard to keep it a secret from Bonnie Apu, which was fun. Like, we kept making excuses to go out.
And then Maisha was like, Bonnie Apu, let's go get some coffee. And I mean, it's very typical of Maisha to like always want to go out and get some coffee. So she's like, let's just do just the girls. And I was like, yeah, sure, fine, whatever. Because I'm sure the guys would have played video games or something.
So I just told her like, hey, you know, Bonnie Apu, the guys are all gonna play video games, so why don't the girls go out for a drive? And she loves that idea. She loves to go on a drive.
We had a little girls trip drive to Target. We went to, you know, get tea and stuff like that. So the first idea I had, like, let's go to Target, at least that'll waste some time. Unfortunately, we only had 30 minutes in Target, so I don't usually drive super fast, but I went fast enough so I'd reach Target on time. And we just cruised Target for the shortest amount of time I've been in Target, because, you know, it's like a hole. You get lost in there forever.
I think it was fun because Maisha really tried her best with trying to, like, drive super slow and, like, hey, what do we do here? Or, like, you know, taking a longer route and everything.
And then I drove so slowly. The slowest I could ever drive, just going like 20 miles per hour, just trying to get to 7-Eleven. And I was just like, guys, I just want to relax today. I just want to relax. And Bonapu was just like, you can go a little faster. And I was like, nah, today I want to relax. So I gave the guys enough time to set up everything. So by the time we got there, everything was set up and it was beautiful.
We decided very early on that, you know, the girls had to distract Bonapu, but the guys had other responsibilities. We had several teams. I think the first thing after the girls left was I told B1Y and Kevin to, you know, immediately get flowers and balloons just for the decorations.
Me and D1, what we did for Bonapu's birthday party is that Ricky had asked us to go to the Stop and Shop and pick up some flowers and a balloon. So I always like riding with D1 because he always tries to impart knowledge, and we always talk like a bunch of bullshit as well as sensible stuff, so it's like a half and half type of thing with us.
I didn't want D1Y to go alone. I asked him to go initially, but I thought, you know, who could possibly, like, keep him company. I couldn't spare a single hand, unfortunately, but Kevin is, he's always ready to volunteer, so. And because he already has such a good rapport with D1Y, I said, hey Kevin, you know, just keep D1Y's company. Pick something nice out, and just come back as soon as you can.
D1 saw this beautiful unicorn rainbow, and both of us were like, that's Bonapu. We literally were like, both of us at the same time pointed and said, that's Bonapu. And he bought it. He actually got it.
We were able to get all of the, you know, the cakes and everything, and all of the decorations and the card and whatnot, but without her figuring it out. So I think it went off pretty well.
Brian and Richie got the cake from Walmart the day before. The cake unfortunately didn't have any writing on it, so Brian bought an icing tube so that we could write later happy birthday. And they were responsible for getting the cake. And then they immediately, when the girls left, they started making the pizzas. With respect to the other guys, I tasked Borno and Javin before they helped out with the pizzas to kind of like work on the cake a little bit.
Oh, this cake is beautiful.
Yes, I gotta write happy birthday. I gotta spell it nicely because they don't want me to.
Here we have the raw cake.
Yeah, they won't write it for us. We gotta do it ourselves.
So basically, what Javin and I did with the cake this year was, initially Ricky brought in the cake, and Ricky tried to do his own writing of happy birthday Bonapu on the cake.
It was Ricky trying to squeeze the bottle and write an H to start writing happy birthday. And it looked like a Hyundai, you know, like the H was all messed up. And like, so then I came, did it real good. Professional! Big mistake though, that took me like, I basically volunteered myself. That took like 30 minutes just to write out happy birthday Bon Cui Cui.
So Javin gave it a try, and it took him like 30, 45 minutes to write down three words, but at the end you just said happy birthday Bon Cui Cui. So I mean, it was pretty lit.
I kind of want to see him finish. Like, I was there at the H.
I was there at the plate.
Only the day ones now.
Is that a Q?
Yeah, it is a Q.
What's up?
Zoom in on the sweat on his forehead from doing this real quick.
Just take these two duffel bags and
see all that sweat? That's hard work and dedication into that kui kui.
Yeah, you know. Came out nice. No, it didn't come out nice, actually. No, I did it real nice and then it all just melted together. And like last minute tried to put it in the fridge, it was already melted. But you can still read it. It was legible.
I have to say my favorite part of the party was making the pizza, because it was pretty fun.
Oh, the pizza. Okay, so
this all goes back to Walt Disney World. Apparently, Walt Disney World, they closed down the Pizza Planet restaurant, and I was, like, really angry because I never had it. But because of this whole pandemic, Disney has licensed the Pizza Planet pizza maker, so I managed to get one at Hot Topic. It was so much fun when I opened it. Take a good look. I give you Pizza Planet.
Basically, this whole pizza situation was pretty fire, I'm not gonna lie. Richie was really good with the details. He was like taking notes down of everything, like all the ingredients and stuff like that, and the things that we actually needed to do step by step.
I realized we had a big group, so we had to make at least two pizzas. So we had two teams. My team consisted of me, Borno, and Taki. And then Brian's team consisted of Javin and Rafi, but then again, Rafi didn't really do much. It was just like filming himself on Instagram the entire time. So it was really Brian and Javin doing a lot.
We made two pizzas just in, you know, celebration. We made it from scratch with Richie's pizza maker from Toy Story. It's pretty cool.
I will have to admit, Borno did do a lot with rolling the dough.
I was the mastermind behind the dough. I'm gonna take all the credit for it because, bro, I sauced it up, as Chef Wire Beats would say himself.
Brian was like the best like co-chef that I ever had.
Got to bond with a white dude for the first time in my life, so it was definitely a one-on-one situation that happened.
Oh yeah, we made pizza. Pizza was good. But to put more cheese and more tomato sauce on it, would have been better. But it was fat. I like fat pizzas. I like them thick. Two C's, three C's, four C's.
The pizza turned out pretty well. It was just a little too thick with four C's. And I think it was like all the hard work that we put in behind it that kind of made it all worth it. So that was definitely my favorite part of the party.
Okay, so we have made our first attempt of a pizza from Pizza Planet. So moment of truth, boys. Here it comes.
Oh!
That looks good.
Yo, this is fire!
We were constantly texting. We were constantly checking with each other, just making sure that everything was copacetic and everything was on time. But eventually, once the pizzas were done, once we finished with the decorations, we called Maisha Poon and we gave her the all clear to come back home.
All right, fine, John, go. They have the house key on the car.
They're pulling your dad now.
Who is it?
Holy shit. This is strong.
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Yes! That's why we went on the stupid ride!
Marsha, that'll be in the video.
Zoom it in.
Thank you, guys. Come here, I want to give everybody a big hug. Everyone, all you guys, get in here. Girls, guys, everyone. Get in here, V1, Richie. Thank you. I love you all.
Now I gotta get off.
Okay. I felt the glizzy on my back.
Look at that. Bonnie had no idea. Totally. Like it was a successful surprise, I can say, for her birthday. And I think she liked it.
She had like no idea. It was such a surprise for her. So it was like exciting to see her being excited and surprised.
I think she was legitimately surprised, and from what I could tell, she was, you know, generally moved, and I think it went well.
I suspected nothing. I didn't suspect a damn thing. I mean, it was very characteristic of Maisha to just want to go out and do stuff and waste time, whatever, or shop in the middle of the night. So by the time we came back, I saw some lights and I was like, what's going on? And I'm so dense, I still didn't think, oh shit, it's because of my birthday, because I had forgotten it was my birthday. So I walk in and I see all the guys, and A Very Merry Unbirthday is playing, because it was still technically not the 20th, it was the 19th. And they just did this great thing. They got a cake and Javin wrote on it. He wrote, happy birthday, Bon Kui Kui, which I loved. I loved it. I think Brian and Richie picked out the cake. Ricky did all the they all organized. Everybody. Ricky, they won everyone. They got me a Wonder Woman card, which I loved. And, you know, it's those times where, like, I'm just so embarrassed to talk about it, but I was really touched. I'm touched by this every time, you know. I still don't suspect it, and I'm touched by it all the time.
I'm glad that you liked it. I'm glad that we all got to write something on your card, and I really hope you enjoyed it. Again, I'm going to say the same thing that I wrote down. This day was amazing. We enjoy your company, your food. I hope you enjoyed our company as well.
Thank you all!
Yeah. All right, well, there's cheesecake courtesy of Kiki Apple. Everyone, thanks, Kiki Apple. Yay.
Yay. I got $100! I love you guys. I love everyone in this group. And, you know, I hope we're together in some capacity for the rest of our lives, inshallah.
You've been touching me the whole night. No,
oh, what?
I told him many occasions. He doesn't.
Stop drinking him, bro. Stop moving.
This beach day was just a perfect little, you know, 2-day break for me. And it was great with the, being with the group.
I feel like we're a pretty solid group. Not even pretty solid. We're a brawly guys group. We've all known each other since we were all in diapers, pretty much.
I like everyone. Everyone's very nice and everyone has their own personality and I think we all get along. It was nice to like see new people and familiar faces as well.
The other day I had some people come over and turns out it's Ricky, his brother and his sister. So the first time I meet them, they're like, oh, you call me Apu and Bhaiya. So I'm like, all right, we'll think about it. But like, you know, as I get to know them, they were like super chill, right? And then they introduced me to this, like, you know, these super cool people and that we end up going to the beach with. And I'm really glad that, you know, they've accepted me for who I am because I do tend to say crazy shit, but they're fine with it. And I love these people, you know, we had a lot of fun together and they get my jokes and I get their jokes and that's all that matters.
We're like hella open. We let a lot of young kids in, we let a lot of older people in, so yeah, I mean, it's a pretty solid group.
The group really felt like a one big, huge family that, like, you know, everybody is, like, sort of different, but we all come together and have a lot of fun, we care for each other. Even Brian, like, I've never met him before, but he was perfect, it felt like he was always there. There's a strong sense of camaraderie. Brotherhood, friendship, family. It was great.
Oh yeah, I mean everybody was great. I mean of course I've known Bonnie for a long time. We were at school together, and then I've already been up here once, actually twice, and so I know the her brothers really well, and you know Maisha and Kevin and. Mirza that I'd already met, so, and then everybody else that I'd met on the day, and Dewan, I'd met Dewan before, and they're all really great, of course, so, and then everybody I met at the beach, or the day of the beach, I mean, they were awesome. I mean, it was really like, I felt like one of the group, man. I mean, it was great.
And meeting a new friend who traveled all the way to New York, that is Brian, I really liked everything. Every bit of it. I enjoyed.
I felt like one of the group the entire time I was here. Really felt like, I was really welcomed with open arms. Didn't feel awkward or anything. I mean, I was very, everybody made me feel really relaxed and at home. I loved y'all, man. I loved being here. I really appreciate everybody inviting me and being so cool. And I think there's a very good possibility I would be back in the near future.
I really, really look forward to like many events that this group have. I look forward to like, there are some things in this group that we just do, which is Thanksgiving, Beach Day, sometimes Christmas, because I'm Christian, we actually have that too. And many other times that this group just come together. And it's just, we always, always have fun. No matter if we have to improvise, if something doesn't go as planned, it's easy to just, it's just very easygoing people that just comes together and just makes it work. And so the games, everything, every gathering that we have is just a complete success because of the great people in this group. And I love every, each and one of them.
This group, I think it's gone beyond friendship and just group. We're kind of a family, and I think what really helps us continue to be a family is that we're all very like-minded in the sense that we're all very chill. We don't take ourselves very seriously, so we don't have to, it's not like we're walking on eggshells. We don't have to like control what we say around each other. We're free enough to like, I don't know, make fun of each other, make fun of ourselves, take a laugh, take a joke. And everyone's kind of on equal footing, which is great.
I see us all as a family, you know. I was introduced to this group through my best friend, Maisha. And when getting to know everybody in this group, I really feel like we are family in terms of like we insult each other, we love each other, we're there for each other. And I just feel like completely comfortable in terms of like this group is some is a type of group that the members of this group can really be there if you're going through a tough time. They're not there for just the fun times.
I really, really hope that it stays, that we can maintain this camaraderie for a really long time. And hopefully it'll be a really fun, like even when we're like super old, it'll be like a really fun thing to share with our children that we were able to maintain this kind of family. You know, any type of relationship requires a lot of work, and I think we all put in that effort and work to the group to maintain our relationship and bond with each other. So super grateful.
We could be growing old and still be doing stuff like this because we have such togetherness with each other. You know what I mean? It goes beyond friendship with this.
I am very lucky, honored, and blessed to be a part of this group. Definitely, I'm also not a very quiet or sane person in that context. So I like crazy stuff sometimes. That gives me, I feel like you need some oxygen for your life. Everybody has their chaos and their job and their responsibility to take care. So a little craziness comes as a dessert, like a sweet dessert. So this meeting this group and being friend with them is the same feeling for me. It's a celebration.
How do you feel our family? Everybody gets together, everybody has fun. That's it. Even though we don't see each other every day, but whenever we see it, the connection is there.
I love this group. I love being with this group. I think it's the perfect group. It's just so much fun because it's like we're all happy. We're all chilling and stuff. Like I think it's people who I trust very much. And I would love to have more days, more events with this group. Like I hope like we get to go camping someday with this group. I hope we get to go to more movie theaters. And I would love to do this whole beach day again, maybe with more people.
The group seems to. There's always people coming in and going out of the group, and we invite that. But there's always like a core group of people that stick around, and I really hope like more people join that core group of people, because it's something to hang out with people, and then there's something to grow up with people, and I always hope that we can all grow up together, because a lot of us have grown up together, and that we continue growing up together, and hopefully our kids will even grow up together. So, yeah, the group means a lot to me because I wouldn't want to take this into the future if it didn't mean so much.
No matter what, we've always been really lucky in how we sort of just click and how we all really love and respect each other. And we just always want to be together. We just always want to be together. And we have so much fun together. And no one's like super sensitive. We have fun with each other. We're all comfortable with each other. Honestly, I think it's a huge blessing. It's a huge blessing because not everyone gets this kind of dynamic. Not everyone has such a core community that they could call upon. So I'm just really thankful to Allah that we have each other. And I hope, I really hope, inshallah, that we all do have each other for years to come.
If this pandemic has taught us anything, it's that you really get to know who your true friends are, who your real family is. And I guess the one real positive thing in addition to that is I really found out how invaluable this group is to me. We always have each other's backs. We're always lending a hand. We're always trying to find ways to support one another. And I think it's because we love this group so much, and because we all love each other so much, that we always try to find time and find ways to shamelessly like spend time together, despite this pandemic. But I honest to God, I can't imagine living life without this group, and I hope we remain like this for a very, very long time.
Almost heaven, West Virginia, Blue Ridge Mountains, Shenandoah River. Life is old there, older than the trees, younger than the mountains, growing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place I belong. West Virginia, mountain mama, take me home, country roads. All my memories gather round her, miner's lady, stranger to blue water. Dark and dusty, painted on the sky, misty taste of moonshine, teardrop in my eye. Country roads, take me home to the place.
Okay, mother bitch, you are on the camera. Now you tell me why you are so much mother bitch.
Super.